What this dying world could use is a willing man of God
who dares to go against the grain and works without applause. A man who raised that shield of faith, protecting what is pure, whose love is tough and gentle, a man whose word is sure. God doesn't need an orator who knows just what to say. He doesn't need authorities to reason him away.
He doesn't need an army to guarantee a win. He just needs a few good men.
Men full of compassion, who laugh and love and cry. Men who face eternity and aren't afraid to die. Men who fight for freedom and honor.
The broken derelict whose life has been renewed. He calls the one who has the strength to stand up for the truth.
Enlistment lines are open and he wants you to come in. He just needs a few good men.
Dear friends, I'd like to take just a few minutes to share with you from my heart to yours a word on this topic, soldiers till death or translation. Again, soldiers till death or translation. My main points will be coming from 2 Timothy chapter 2, verses 1 to 4. Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you so much for the opportunity that has been presented to speak to your people. Lord Jesus, as we gather in this forum, I ask you, Lord, one thing and one thing only, that you will speak through me and that you will speak for me. Father, hide me behind Calvary's cross and let you and you alone be seen, you and you alone be magnified. To this end be your name's praise, honor, and glory, I pray. In Jesus' precious name, amen. 2 Timothy chapter 2, verses 1 to 4, and it reads, Thou therefore, my son, be strong in the grace that is in Christ Jesus, and the things that thou hast heard of me among many witnesses, the same commit thou to a faithful man, who shall be able to teach others also. Verse 3, Thou therefore endure hardness as a good soldier of Jesus Christ. No man that warreth entangleth himself with the affairs of this life, that he may please him who hath chosen him to be a soldier. Dear listener, are you a soldier for Jesus Christ? Are you a soldier of Jesus Christ? Today, as you listen, I'm asking you not to think of yourself as battle-hardened, battle-weary, battle-scarred, but a soldier in terms of, as our introductory song said, Jesus needs a few good men. Not good in terms of God being the only one that is good, but good in terms of the 300 of Gideon. You know, where the majority forsook and they made excuses. Jesus needs men and women today who will forego any excuse and say, I will follow thee, my Savior. Are you among that select few? Dear friends, the word of God is clear, and the understanding is this. No man that warreth entangled himself with the affairs of this life. That's the principle. We are soldiers till death or translation, whichever comes first. And so therefore, we dare not seek to entangle ourselves with the affairs of this life. Every current trend, every new fad, every fashion, every form, and we find ourselves in it. You see, the thing is, my friends, I've become to understand of late that Christianity is not what Christ founded, and this may shock you. Christ did not establish principles on Christianity. A Christian is not a religion. A Christian is a follower of Christ. A Christian is a follower of Him who says, I am the way. And so therefore, when you see what passes today for Christians and Christianity, that is not what Christ set up. His principles are far different from what we see today. Dear listener, this week the thought came to my mind, and I just have to share it with you. In 2018, if Jesus were to walk up to you and shake your hand, would you recognize him? Conversely, if Jesus were to walk in to your church this weekend, would he recognize it? Would he say that upon this rock, this was founded? Or this is an amalgamation or an outright abomination? Friend of mine, going forward, we need to realize that our principle, our chief goal in this life is, as verse 4 says, again, let me read, it says, No man that warreth entangleth himself with the fears of this life, that he may please, keyword, that he may please him who had chosen him to be a soldier. And so I ask the question again, are you a soldier of Jesus Christ? Are you a good and faithful soldier? Friend of mine, the issues are more than just saying yay or realizing nay. The issues go deeper, my friend. This week, I had a hard time, and I'm not afraid, I'm not ashamed to confess it, as I looked over the landscape of what passes for Christianity today. This week, as we know, it'll go down in history as the week in which Billy Graham died. Many, many Christians, millions of Christians, look upon Billy Graham as a great evangelist and a good soldier of Jesus Christ. The question is, can others coming up look upon you, I, as good and faithful soldiers of Jesus Christ? You know, like I said, as I've been looking at the landscape, I have, and in all honesty, all these people have some truth that they do speak. And I could say amen, because whether it comes from Catholic or heretic, as Martin Luther said, the truth is the truth. Friends, the sad thing is, though, that following the amen, I have to go, oh man, what comes next is an utter repudiation of Scripture. And I have to shake my head, because I'm wondering, do these men and women read the Word of God that they are expounding to the people? But also, do the people read the Word of God that's being quoted to them? And you know, that is the greater issue. Because as I sit here and as I'm speaking to you, I'm realizing that those words that were spoken to Timothy, that from a child he knew the Holy Scriptures, cannot be said of the majority of us nowadays. Oh, dear friends, what have we become? What have we sunk to? I tell you the truth. We need to get back to that place. Wherever it was and whatever it was, we need to get back to it. We do. So I'll just say, we don't read our Bibles, we don't have an active prayer life, we don't talk to God as we ought. Friends, I have to say it, we are desperately in trouble. And so, as you're hearing this, I say to you again, are you a soldier of Jesus Christ? Are you willing to be a soldier till death or translation, whichever comes first? And I'm telling you, and it may sound so, but I'm telling you, this it's not calling for a works program. It's not. It's calling for a realization, an understanding that I am not where I ought to be. Thank God I'm not where I used to be, but I'm not where I ought to be. It's 2018, and we need to do some very, very heavy introspection. It's time that we stop pointing the finger at the other man, the next man, and saying they, him, her, that situation, this situation, and put the blame squarely where it ought to be. It is I. We need to take back up the banner of Prince Emmanuel and march from victory unto victory. Dear listener, what are you doing with the message of this glorious gospel that has been delivered to you? Seriously, it's a serious question. What are you doing with this beautiful gospel message? Are you allowing it to transform you? Are you allowing it to make and to shape you? I pray that you say yes. I don't know about you, but this one thing I do know. This one thing I do know for sure. Time is wrapping up. I'll tell you something, dear listener. Again, as I sit here and contemplate the landscape of Christianity, I realize that many of us are in trouble. Why? Because we are not willing to own up. And that's
a problem, because if we're not willing to own up to the fact that, yes, I have these issues, then God cannot do anything for us. It's not that he will not, it's that he cannot. He cannot do that which is needed for us, because we will not acknowledge that we have a problem. A good soldier realizes his limitations. A good soldier understands that he is incapable of doing a certain task. A good soldier would recognize he needs to go to his superiors for help. Again, I ask you, dear listener, are you a good soldier of Jesus Christ? Please, I beg of you, do not let the sands of time expire and you're left in the utterly deplorable condition that does not speak to the God of the universe who ransomed you, who redeemed you. Friend of mine, I pray that as we go forward, as we conclude our lives here in time and prepare to spend eternity with our Savior, that we become soldiers once again in the army of the Lord, that we realize that we have failed him in so many ways. Not that he looks at us as failures, he does not. That's the beauty of our God. He loves us so much and he looks at us with love. But again, we are acknowledging, we are introspecting, we have failed him. We have not done our due diligence. Therefore, like I said, the landscape of Christianity is not what it was founded upon. And so many people are misguided as to what and who they are. Dear listener, Jesus wants you this morning. Jesus wants you to engage in this battle in the end times. Like we read in our scripture, you must be prepared to cast everything else aside. Every earthly interest must be made secondary to that which matters most. Friend, are you prepared to be a soldier in the army of the Lord? Soldier, not just in life, not just enjoying all the benefits that comes with soldiering, but be prepared to be a soldier till death. If that is your desire, please pray with me. Heavenly Father, indeed, we have failed you in so many ways. We have not lived up to our full potential. But today, dear Lord, you have spoken to our hearts. And because we're desirous of listening, oh Lord, we hear you. Speak to our hearts, Lord Jesus. Come and tell us where we're lacking so that we can fall on our knees at the foot of the cross and plead for deliverance over our defects. Heavenly Father, help us to be good and faithful soldiers of yours, not just in this life, but up until death, or translation. Lord, there's so many who do not know you as Lord and Savior. So many who do not acknowledge you as Lord. And in this moment, Father, I pray that those of us who claim to know you, that we will avail of ourselves everything that heaven has for us to be equipped as good soldiers for Jesus. Lord, help us not to neglect, help us not to reject that which is ours, but to gladly receive it in all readiness. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for this time spent in speaking to your people. I pray that even one, O God, will listen and say, you know what, Jesus, that's me. I have not been so good a faithful soldier of yours. Others can't see Jesus in me, and it is my fault. And so, Jesus, right now, I come and I acknowledge and I forsake. And I want to be one of those few good Gideon band members, O Lord. Heavenly Father, I pray that such a decision would have been made. Help us to be Daniels and Esthers in these last days, O God. True to principle as the needless to the pole. O Lord, help us to fix our minds that no matter what, we will be soldiers again in the army of the Lord. Bless us now, dear God, as we separate from this forum, and I pray that you will bring us back again so that we can listen to many more messages of truth and life, but more importantly, live that truth, that way, and that life is my prayer, and I pray all of our prayers in Jesus' precious name. Amen.
Fought the enemy with little toys, sticks for swords, hands for guns, every battle always won. But as we grew and went our ways, we forgot about our soldier days. No more swords and no more guns, no more battles to be won. We were wrong, we could not see, we still had an enemy. Now we stand friend with friend. We
are soldiers once again.
We are soldiers again in the army of the Lord. We are soldiers again, and His word is our sword. We will not be denied. With Him by our side, we know the victory we'll win. We will fight to the end, soldiers again. The one we are fighting, but we stand with one who can, the Lord God Almighty. We are soldiers again in the army of the soldiers again, and His word is our sword. We will not be denied. With Him by our side, we know the victory we'll win. We will fight to the end, soldiers again. Side, we know the victory we'll win. We will fight to the end, soldiers again.